So if the point of MFA programs, if the point of MFA programs were as a training ground for people to become writers, it would seem to make sense to train people in genres where they can hope to make a living. And we're saying that literary fiction is not that, or often not that, a genre where one writer can make a living. So what is then the mandate for an MFA program? If it's not to train writers to make a living, it's to do what exactly?
Maybe the way they make their living is by teaching, which is something he talks about in that article.
Yeah.
There is I cannot remember the author's name, but there's a really interesting article on the Millions called Teaching the Business of Creative Writing. And the argument that he puts forth is that MFA programs do a really big disservice to not teach any of the aspects of publishing, how to do query letters, to how to analyze the marketplace. And from my own experience, none of that stuff was really talked about. Even like how to put together a CV wasn't talked about. So if like you're going to go teach, that wasn't dealt with, at least in my program. And so I think an MFA program, if I was going to design one, it would incorporate aspects of book layout and design and marketing and how to read publishing numbers and all that stuff. And so I think it's twofold. It should be to teach how to write. It should be how to teach, in my opinion, because I was talking to a U of O student, and I found this really interesting. They teach there. The first year, they are all allowed to teach creative writing, fiction classes, because the idea was, since they're there to study fiction, they already know how to teach it, we'll give it to them first. The second year, then they teach composition, that's supposedly harder to teach. And I thought that was a really sort of perverse way of looking at it. It's not quite right. That I think teaching fiction is really difficult. Just teaching in general is very, very challenging. And I think that's another issue I had with the article, is that it's just something writers go do. And that it doesn't take as much work to be a great teacher as it does to be a great writer. And I think it does take a lot of work.
Is it art for art's sake? Is that what MFA programs do?
I think MFA programs should. I mean, if you're getting an MFA in creative writing, it's a good time to write and not worry about the marketplace, because there's going to be plenty of time to worry about the marketplace. But I think a writer needs time to write, and one of the great things about MFA programs is when they're funded, and that's what you want. If you're interested in going to an MFA program, you want to be paid to go. You want to be paid to spend 2 years writing and exploring the kind of work that's important to you, and then you have plenty of time. You're going to have the rest of your life to worry about the marketplace and like that. Now, as a publisher and a writer, going to Book Expo and the Frankfurt Book Fair and the London Book Fair, it was horrifying. I just thought no writer should see this. Ever. Because the business of books is it's about the writing, but it's I don't think you can. Well, some people can write toward a commercial market. I don't know a bunch of people like that. I know they're out there. I mean, a lot of people I know are writing from a different place. In the marketplace, I think maybe that would be the third year.
Yeah.
So if we're designing a program, that would be the third year.
And I think it's important to recognize that colleges, even though this maybe is not a cool thing to say anymore, maybe one of the last places that you can spend some time where all of your thoughts and feelings are not immediately instrumentalized into something that you could do to make a living. Which then, of course, leads people to start thinking about maybe I should change my thoughts and emotional responses in certain ways so that I could make a better living. So things I wasn't okay with, but if I learned to be okay with them, then I could become a lawyer. That's what I discovered. There's plenty of time for that, as Lee said. What college, and I don't know if this is about MFA degrees or college in general, what I think it offers an opportunity for people to do is to work on something in more of a, you know, God, this is awful that the person that's teaching at a college right now is going to sit and bring up Plato, but it has to be done. But, you know, in some ways you want the place to still have a kind of platonic sense that we could talk just about ideals. Could we talk about what might make a good story, not what might make a story that sells a lot? Could we this year just talk about, but sales things aside, money and fame aside, what would be good? What would be good? And that's a very difficult question. And it produces interesting discussion, and students write and revise their work in really interesting ways when the question of what would be good is not attached to some kind of instrumentalized thing. The market will come and devour you as soon as you step off campus. So you're going to get it. And I think that there are, in good programs, I think there are opportunities to study the market. We have the publishing program at PSU where students have exactly that opportunity. I think that that's why that's valuable. And I think that sometimes the MFA workshop is the place where you can meet a person. Hopefully some of your fellow students, but it would be nice if your instructor sometimes was also one of those people that said, listen, I don't care if your writing is going to make a lot of money. I want to ask you some things about what you're trying to do and how you might do it. And people don't have that many opportunities for that in their lives, and I think it's a valuable opportunity.
I agree.
Thank you.
Do you want to know what Chad says about that, though?
I don't know. I'm tired of Chad.